Hi, I'm Henrik Ebeklint. In this video, we will go through how to choose the correct Anybus gateway for your connectivity needs. Basically, an Anybus gateway is a translator where you connect one communication standard on one side and another communication standard on the other. There are more than 300 combinations of most industrial communication standards on the market. So, let's have a look at how it works. If you want to connect a serial or CAN-based device to a network, simply select your sub-network interface first, and then the industrial network you want to connect to. You will get the correct gateway for this combination. In this example, the solution was an Anybus communicator, which will act as a slave on the Profibus network, translating information to and from the serial device. If you want to connect two similar or dissimilar industrial networks, you first need to know if your network infrastructure has one PLC master, which should communicate to several slaves, or if you have a PLC master on the other network as well. The reason for this is that if you have two PLCs, the gateway will be slave on both sides. If you only have one PLC, the gateway will be slave to the PLC and act as a master to the slaves on the subnetwork. Confusing? Well, let's have a look at some examples to explain this further. In our first example, we have an Allen Bradley ControlLogix PLC, which uses an Ethernet IP network. We want to use a gateway to integrate the Profibus automation devices into the ControlLogix PLC. Consequently, the gateway is a slave on the Ethernet IP network. Since there is no controlling PLC master for the Profibus devices, the Anybus gateway acts as a master in this case, saving you the cost of an additional master. So, the solution here is an Anybus X gateway, which is an Ethernet IP slave and a Profibus master. In our second example, we have two modicon controlling PLCs. We want to use a gateway to connect an older part of the factory, which uses a CAN open network, to a new part, which has a Modbus TCP network. The solution here is an Anybus X gateway, which is slave on both sides and simply sends the transparent I/O data between the two networks. I choose my gateway on Anybus.com by selecting CAN open slave and Modbus TCP slave. Okay. So this is not really rocket science, but what makes gateway selection a little bit confusing is that different networks use different terminology for master and slave. In Modbus TCP, the master is called client, while CANopen calls it manager. In the SIP networks, Ethernet IP, DeviceNet, and ControlNet, the master is called scanner. The devices being controlled are usually called slaves, but they are called servers if you use Modbus TCP, and adapters in the SIP networks. To confuse things even further, you have the term devices for slaves in the Profibus and Profinet networks. So, for example, if you need slave-to-slave communication between Modbus TCP and Ethernet IP, then you should select Modbus TCP server and an Ethernet IP adapter. Confused? Well, luckily there are Anybus gateways to interpret between all these incompatible technologies, so you don't have to worry about the different terminologies and standards. An HMS is here to help. Get in contact with us and we will help you sort it out.